So the last mile around AI adoption is critical. The reason is you have a lot of AI technologies that are out there. You know, most of it is consumer grade, as you know, lots of people are using ChatGPT and various other technologies. But for enterprises to adopt AI, it has to be done in a safe manner and in a reliable manner. And that's why it's very important for us to be able to take that technology and be able to have enterprises adopt it in a way that their consumers can use it in the right way possible. Complexity is part of the problem. The other part of the problem is that there's a myriad of these technologies that are available. So for a company to really figure out what exactly they need to solve their problem is part of the puzzle. So to be able to bring the right technologies together and be able to blend them in such a way that you're able to provide the solution that you're looking for. And that's where Cognizant's platforms come in, because they do that in a way that actually takes away the complexity and really provides the solution in a safe and secure way that your enterprise can use it. There are multiple technologies out there. Some of them do certain tasks really well. So the role that Cognizant plays is to really understand what you're looking for. What is the problem that you are trying to solve? And then bring the various technologies. And if there are gaps, we fill those gaps in with our platforms so that we can provide you a holistic solution. All of our platforms are AI enabled, powered by AI. So we have platforms that deal with specific issues and challenges that clients have. So for example, we have a platform that is known as Neuro IT Operations that actually runs every aspect of a client's IT estate, whether it's applications or its infrastructure. It runs it holistically end to end. We have another platform that we released last year, which is all about applications, which is called Flowsource. Our latest platform is a platform called Neuro AI Engineering, which allows you to infuse AI into everything that you're doing. So we have multiple platforms, all meant to solve different challenges that our clients are looking for resolutions around. What we do with these platforms is we are able to bring all of the AI that's there in a safe and secure manner, in a way that you're able to apply those things very quickly. Because clients struggle with all of the different technologies that are out there, and more importantly, how quickly can you actually implement these things? These platforms bring all of these technologies very quickly and safely to your particular organization. When you look at savings, there's three different ways that we look at it. We have a three-vector strategy. The first is productivity. So AI can immediately offer you productivity savings across a lot of things that you do. I'll start with code development. So just building code, being able to maintain code, etc., with the help of AI, allows us to save quite a bit for our clients. It depends on how much they're able to put into their estates, but it's a significant amount. So that's the first part. The second part is actually infusing AI into existing applications and making them more efficient. The third vector is really about creating new products and services that don't exist today that AI is going to be able to enable. So there's multiple things. There's absolutely savings, because you're reducing the amount of human effort that's needed. You'll still have a human in the loop, but lots of it is going to be done by the machine. So that is huge savings. The second is you're going to have better output. You're going to have better quality. So that's, in a sense, going to provide you savings. And the third is speed to market, because that's extremely important for our clients to be able to get their products and services out there. So self-healing IT is a great example. So if you look at organizations, they tend to spend 30, 40, 50%, depends on the organization, around just running their systems. So they have all of these different technologies and infrastructure, and they've got things that are going on in their estate, and about half the budget, give or take, goes into actually fixing problems that occur. So what you're able to do now with AI is that it's able to actually recognize a problem that happens, and the next time that problem recurs, you don't need a human in the loop. The technology is able to solve the problem by itself. That's what is called self-healing. So as it continues to learn, you know, there might be a new problem that happens. that's fine. You're going to have a human solve it, but the AI is going to pick that up and understand how it's going to solve it the next time. So it's you know, a cycle where more and more things happen, and the system is actually able to self-heal itself. We have, you know, over 10 different platforms, depending on the aspect of the problem that you're trying to solve. Like I said, Neuro IT operations is to run your estate, Flowsource is to actually build new applications, etc. We have over 400 clients who are using our platforms in some way, shape, or form, and increasingly, we are offering all of our services underpinned by these platforms, and clients are seeing the power of these platforms and how they are able to adopt AI, because it's all about embedding AI and using it in a safe manner, but also being able to scale up very quickly. What excites me most is, I mean, and this is fascinating because this is developing at a, you know, at a pace that is not been seen before. And you know, AI used to be sort of what we would call a pair programmer, you know, so somebody that's assisting you, to where we see it now as a peer programmer. So AI is actually going to be sitting with you in helping you solve problems. So I think the, you know, opportunities are boundless. It really comes down to being able to envision the ways in which AI can solve and help, you know, change the future for us. So it's going to be very much embedded in everything that we do. Neuro AI Engineering is our latest platform that we released earlier in the year. And I think it's going to be fundamental for us to implement AI at our clients. So we see AI being used in a couple of different ways. In the traditional way, using various chatbots that leverage large language models, but more importantly, with agentification, Neuro AI Engineering is going to help us build various agents and a whole set of agents for our clients, agents that talk to one another, agents that work with humans to solve problems, etc. So what this does for our clients is provides a platform that seamlessly allows them to build agents for their specific problems using the best technology that's available. There's a variety of tools that are available out there. I think what we are able to do with our platforms is actually seamlessly bring those tools to developers so that they can use that. And really, it's all about how this is getting democratized so that different people can bring the power of AI to solve different problems. You know, it allows you to get solutions to your client at speed, and it really reduces the cost. And more importantly, I think the, you know, the kind of quality that you're going to get out is going to be phenomenal. AI models that you see, agentic models, are not plug and play. They solve different problems, but really for you to solve a problem or to, you know, provide a solution to a client, you have to be able to have the right platform that brings all of them together seamlessly. So while they are not plug and play, at Cognizant we're able to provide the right enterprise grade platform solution to actually get the power of these products that are out there.